am Gupta Anubha. So we'll start with the topic. I'm going to take the biology topic, circulation. So what is basically a circulation? Circulation is can also be called as vascular flow or vascular system flow, in which the blood flows in the body, cavities. So it can flow into the cavities or it can flow into the channels, right? So circulation is a wholesome process which is very much important for a body to support the life, because whatever we consume is actually placed or passed to the body parts in the very corner part of it because of the blood and the fluid which is circulating in the body. Circulation is one such process. How often we can say that it is such an important process which helps to get all the kind of nutrients and to remove all the kind of waste products. So basically, what is circulation? Circulation, the process of flow of blood to every part of the body with the help of vessels or in the cavity is called as circulation. So basically, on the topic of vessels, whether the vessel is present or the cavity is, the directly blood is flowing in the cavity, accordingly there are two different types of the circulation. The circulation can be divided into two types, that is basically first one is closed circulation and second one is open circulation. So basically it is the kind of the flow in which open circulation is calculated as most primitive, because the simple organism like the planaria is there, cockroaches are there, okay? So these organisms are basically having the open kind of circulation. In the circulation, the body blood flows in the body cavity. Cilium meaning body cavity. So blood flows in the cavity. Blood flows directly in the cavity. It is not flowing in any kind of the transport channel. It is not flowing in the vessels, or you can say the tubules. It is not flowing in that. Directly, whatever the blood fluid is there, it is directly bathing, or you can say it is wetting all the organs which is found inside the body very efficiently, very directly. So close contacts are there between the blood and the organs. So this is called as open circulation, which is a common type of circulation you see in the simple organism. I gave you the example like the arthropods. Most of the arthropods are the best example for that, who show that they are having the open kind of circulation. So next one is closed circulation. So closed circulation is that the blood flows in closed channel. Closed channel meaning the blood flows into the blood vessels. Okay? So blood vessels helps the blood to pass from every one part to the other part of the body in a very profound manner, not help or not let the organs to be dipped into it. Basically, if you see or if you dissect an organism who have the close kind of circulation, so all the organs are well visible in there. That is called as closed circulation. So closed circulation is a kind of circulation in which the blood flows directly or only into the blood vessels. Okay? So that is called as closed circulation. This is found in the simple type of organism like earthworm. You can see earthworms are there, fishes are there, human beings are there. They are the organisms who have the closed type of circulation. So basically what they say, whatever the organ are there or whatever the channels are there, the blood will flow in the closed manner, in the packed manner. See? Then circulatory system comes there, because circulation is not a simple process. It is a kind of process which occurs with the help of a more than one organ, because whatever the fluid is there is flowing is actually helped by the pumping action. So whatever the activity is done of circulation is basically done with the help of the circulatory system and the organs. So what is system? We can say the organs bound together to function for the circulation is called as circulatory system. So whatever the organs are, basically the first organ which is very much important is the heart. In case of closed circulation, in case of open circulation, both the organism requires heart, which is very much important because heart is a pumping organ which helps the blood to pump. So these exerting force which helps the blood to ooze out of the body is helping the body ooze out in the body cavity, helps the blood to flow from one portion to the another portion of the body. So next one is blood vessels. So blood vessel, in the case of closed circulation, the blood vessels helps the transportation of the blood or any kind of the liquid which is flowing in the body very in a precise manner, in a profuse manner, in a very good manner. Then next one is the blood. So it is a liquid form. This is the important thing which is circulated in the body, which helps the transportation of the nutrient, which helps the transportation of the waste material from the use area to the area from where it is to be excreted. It helps the antibodies, the fighting bodies of the body, to circulate in all the parts and to help the germs to eliminate out of the body. So we will stop here. So further we will continue in the next lecture. Thank you very much.